So welcome to this practice of Yoga Nidra. And having taken the time to make sure that you are warm and comfortable, so that you are really able to settle and give yourself this time and this space for deep, nourishing rest. And as the body starts to move into stillness, softly notice all the sounds around you. Maybe sound outside of the room, or sounds inside of the room. The sound of your breath. And simply know that now is the time. There is nothing else that you need to be doing. There is nowhere else that you need to be. You simply be here. Taking this practice of Yoga Nidra is more than enough. And start to feel now that the body becomes heavier. And so the whole weight of the body was simply giving itself back down to the earth. The muscles and the bones beginning to become a little bit heavier. And the breath just softly flowing in and out with no effort, no control needed. Take a moment here to take your awareness to your heart space, your space of compassion and love. And consider if there is anything that you need from this practice. Perhaps just the opportunity to rest, to nourish the soul, or to simply explore how it is to be in the state of Yoga Nidra. Maybe there is no intention, just a simple prayer of gratitude to have this opportunity to be taking this practice at this time. And feel the whole body now. The whole body. This whole body as a little piece of the earth. Beautiful piece of the earth, so much longing for rest. And prepare to take your full awareness to each part of the body that I mention. And it's as though the body is the fertile soil of the earth. And at each part of the body that I mention, you place a small seed, planting a small seed, perhaps to meet your intention, or perhaps just in the promise that something new will be growing and emerging in your life. Starting with the tip of the tongue and the roof of the mouth, the floor of the mouth, the inner right cheek, the inner left cheek, the bottom lip, the upper lip, the bottom jaw, and the upper jaw, planting a seed at the right ear and the left ear, and the very tip of the nose, the right eye, and the left eye, and a seed at that space between the eyebrows, the crown of the head, and the back of the head, the base of the skull, and the back of the neck. Placing a new seed into the soft skin of the throat and on the right shoulder, the upper arm, the elbow, the forearm, and the wrist. The top of the hand, and a seed resting in the palm of the hand, and the tip of the thumb, the tip of the index finger, the tip of the middle finger, the tip of the ring finger, and the tip of the little finger. So this right arm was the perfect breeding ground for new ideas. And taking the awareness back up the arm to the left shoulder and upper arm, the elbow, the forearm, and the wrist, the seed at the back of the hand, and one in the palm of the hand, the thumb, and the index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and little finger, the whole left arm, and both arms together. Taking the awareness down to the breastbone and planting a new seed behind the left breast, back to the breastbone, a seed behind the right breast, and back to the breastbone. Right shoulder blade, the left shoulder blade, the middle back, the lower back, and the abdomen. And how would it feel if your intention were true to have more rest, more nourishment? Or simply to be open to receive. Take the awareness to the back of the pelvis, planting seeds here, to the front of the pelvis, the pubis bones, the pelvic floor, the right hip and left hip, and sense the whole pelvis, the whole pelvis, and feel that the pelvis is a bit like a bowl filled with water that's going to allow these seeds to nourish and grow. To the right thigh now, and the back of the thigh, the kneecap, and back of the knee, the shin, and calf, and the ankle, the seed on the top of the right foot, the sole of the right foot, the right big toe, and the second toe, third toe, fourth toe, and little toe, the whole right leg, and take your awareness up the right leg, across to the left hip, and to the left thigh, and back of thigh, the kneecap, and back of knee, the shin, calf, and the ankle, the top of the foot, and the sole of the foot, and the whole left leg. Feeling both legs together, both arms together, and feeling the breath flowing in and out. As though the breath were the air circulating around the earth of the body. And the next time you come to breathe in, feel the whole body on the inhalation. And as you exhale, feel the whole left side of the body. Breathing in, feeling the whole body. And breathing out, feeling the right side. On an inhalation, feeling the whole body down to the fingers and the toes, and as you exhale, feeling the left side of the body. And breathing in this way. On each exhale, feeling one side of the body. And on the inhale, feeling the whole body. Next time you come to inhale fully, on the exhale, feel the whole body, left side and right side, feeling the whole body. And know I am whole. I am complete. I am perfect as I am. The breath simply coming and going. The body simply resting. Nothing for you to do. Notice now that those seeds that you have planted perhaps are starting to blossom and bloom. Some perhaps turning into glorious trees and flowers, so that soon the whole body is like a beautiful garden or woodland, everything fully bloomed. There is colour and sun, and everything feels alive. And then you notice some of the leaves are starting to drop away, turning greeny brown as they fall to the earth. And autumn is coming. There is a chill in the air, and it's time to get ready to harvest all that you have sown. And still you watch as winter comes and everything is laid out bare, and there may not be sun and there may not be greenery, but deep in the soil of the body there are new seeds waiting to start to grow. And you simply watch all of this, knowing that there is nothing to do. No effort to be made. And simply resting, watching the glorious unfolding. And if you are practicing this at home, you're welcome to just stay resting here. Otherwise, know that we come to the end of this practice. To the end of this practice of Yoga Nidra. And I will share a poem with you now. And as you listen to the poem, you're also welcome to perhaps start to stretch and yawn and sigh, just nice and quietly, so we can all hear the poem. I bless the night that nourished my heart to set the ghosts of longing free into the flow and figure of dream that went to harvest from the dark, bread for the hunger no one sees. All that is eternal in me welcomes the wonder of this day, the field of brightness it creates, offering time for each thing to arise and illuminate. I place on the altar of dawn the quiet loyalty of breath, the tent of thought where I shelter, waves of desire I am shorn to, and all beauty drawn to the eye. May my mind come alive today to the invisible geography that invites me to new frontiers, to break the dead shell of yesterdays, to risk being disturbed and changed. May I have the courage today to live the life that I would love, to postpone my dream no longer, but to do at last what I came here for, and waste my heart on fear no more. May I have the courage today to live the life that I would love, to postpone my dream no longer, but to do at last what I came here for, and waste my heart on fear no more. So beginning to stretch and wiggle and yawn, and anything else that you need to do to reawaken from this state of yoga nidra as this practice of yoga nidra comes to an end and you come back to this waking world.